What's cooking, everybody? Dave Altizer here with Kinoteca. Today we're talking about the Canon M50 for video. The Canon M50 is actually a really surprising little camera from Canon. Seems like it was an accident because, in my opinion, I actually believe that the M50 is one of the best deals in Canon's entire lineup. For $700, you get 1080p at 60 frames per second with dual pixel autofocus, 120 frames per second in 720p, and 4K. In fact, you're watching this video shot on the M50 right now in 4K. It looks good, right? There are some limitations with the 4K, and we will get into details about that later in the video and how to work around those things. But if you learn how to utilize this camera and squeeze it for all it's worth, I actually think this camera is pretty dang good. We get the dual pixel autofocus all the way up to 60 frames per second, which is great for slow-mo shots or if you want to shoot in 60 if you're a YouTuber or something. And it's really great. The autofocus is really reliable, the face tracking works a charm, and we have the digital IS stabilization, which is kind of a hit or miss. If you're really running around, you don't want to have it on because it'll look really messy and you definitely want to use a gimbal for most things. But if you're just handheld and you're using a lens that maybe doesn't have IS, then it's great. It really stabilizes the shot and it doesn't look too funky or weird. The 1080p mode is great, but what about the slow motion mode, the 120 frames per second? Well, it's in 720p, which normally shouldn't be that big of an issue, but this is not a good 720p. There's tons of image issues with aliasing and moire. You also lose autofocus, so it's manual focus only, which isn't that big of a problem because this camera does happen to have focus peaking. We'll touch on that later as we get into the 4K, which leads me to 4K. Now, when you first hear about this camera's 4K mode and how it crops in on the image, going from an aps-c 1.6x crop to a 2.45x crop, you kind of dismiss this camera for 4K. Not only do we have a major crop in the 4K mode, but we also lose the ability to use a dual pixel autofocus. But here's the little catch and the little amazing thing about this camera. We actually have focus peaking on the M50, which means that you can actually pull focus manually using manual lenses and get away with it. One of the reasons why the M50 is so good for 4K is because of the codec. The 4K on the M50 is really usable because once you're done recording, you can just drop that footage straight into your computer. It saves valuable space because it's a good compression, 150 megabits per second actually, which is better than even Sony's compression system, and it runs really smoothly on your computer. A lot of people talk about 4K not being necessary. I agree with that statement. I don't think everybody has to have 4K. In fact, we've seen Casey Neistat go from the GH5 back to an old Canon camera to shoot 1080 because it's just more reliable and easier for him to make videos.
You'll notice that this video and the videos that I'll be posting in the near future anyways are not 4K. I've gone back to 1080.
But the reason that we shoot 4K and why I personally prefer shooting everything in 4K is because the amount of information that is being captured there is much more than just the resolution. It's capturing more light, it's capturing more shadow detail, it's capturing more color information. And if you actually care about what your images look like and put that extra effort into making your content better, I think that resonates in the videos that you produce and can really help you in your career as a filmmaker. Also, because this camera shoots 4K, it can mix in with other 4K cameras that are much more expensive and more geared for video, like the C200 or the C300 from Canon. Of course, it's not perfect. You have terrible rolling shutter performance, as you can see here. You also, of course, lose that autofocus. So why use this camera? There's a lot of limitations that you don't get from Sony cameras or Fuji cameras or Panasonic cameras if you just need 4K. Well, first off, this camera is really cheap. It's only $600 to $700. Also, straight out of the box, this camera has amazing color science. And that is really something that you can't overemphasize. One of the first things that I would do if I got this camera and I wanted to use it for actual video purposes is buy some sort of cage for it. Now, right now we have it in the wooden camera cage that's designed for the Sony system. It doesn't work perfectly. It does work sort of, but we don't have access to the battery door. So don't buy this one. But it's really more of a proof of concept. There is one coming soon. soon, hopefully from Small Rig. They have a teaser for it on their website. But I definitely would buy a cage because this camera is just so plasticky and so, I don't know, it just feels like it's gonna break in half at any moment. Now, because this has an EFM mount on it, we have a lot of options when it comes to lensing. It's just like a Sony system where we could use all sorts of different adapters. You can go Leica, you could go Nikon, you can use old FD lenses from Canon. But what's really exciting is using a speed booster like we have on here now. When you're shooting 1080p video, you get the equivalent of a full frame image. And when you're shooting 4K, that's really where it gets magical. Using a speed booster on the M50, shooting 4K gives you a Super 35 sensor size equivalent. It's not perfect, it's a 1.7-ish equivalent. Super 35 is usually around 1.5, but hey, I'll call it Super 35. This lens right here is really interesting to me because I feel like it solves a lot of the problems with the 4K mode in particular. And if you're a vlogger who wants a wide angle lens with a faster aperture than what you can get from Canon, it keeps it nice and small and compact. And because it's an F2 aperture, it really helps for those low lights scenarios, and it gives you that nice depth of field that you like. Here's another really fun little thing with this camera. You can buy a little adapter that allows you to put C-mount lenses on the camera. What you can do is buy certain C-mount lenses, not all C-mount lenses, but certain C-mount lenses from roughly like 12 millimeters onward. I was really hoping that this little 8mm lens would serve as a really good wide angle option for this camera in 4K, because with the 2.4x crop on an 8mm lens, you get about a 20mm equivalent, and it's an f1.3, but we have really heavy vignetting. There are some lenses that work really well with the C-mount on this camera if you really want to save some money and get some vintage looks on this camera. Look into the C-mount options. By the way, here's another really great C-mount lens. It's a 12-75mm zoom. Again, 12mm on a 2.4 is wide enough, and 75mm is really tight. And it's a 1.2 aperture. I was really hoping this would work, but it doesn't. It's vignetting, as you can see here. The vignette is really strong, but it was a good idea, right? I did this for you, by the way. But these are going on eBay immediately. Like I said earlier, you can use standard EFS or EF lenses on this camera. I have this speed booster on here, which, by the way, you cannot buy at the moment. However, Viltrox has made an announcement that they are working on one, so we should see one soon. I bought one kind of custom made for you guys. I did a whole video about the speed booster. Check it out in the eye icon above. You can watch that whole video about the speed booster. Using the Canon EF adapter, you can use all sorts of lenses from Canon. This one here is the amazing and infamous 18-135 zoom. This is usually kitted with like an 80D or 70D, and it's a really useful focal range. And believe it or not, the optics are actually pretty good. This, with the adapter on the M50, especially in the 1080p mode, is a great pair. We get the image stabilization going through it. The dual pixel autofocus works great. In fact, Connor McCaskill, our camera operator, used this setup with this adapter on the M50 for the entire time he did this big shoot, and it was really usable. He said the autofocus was great. We did a whole video about his experience using this lens with this adapter on that camera. It was a live stream, so check that out on our channel. It should be up now. And the last thing I want to mention, and I really want you guys to know, and I can't drill home enough, is how good the 22mm f2.0 lens is. I don't think you can get any better with this 22 right here. It's tiny, it looks amazing, and it's one of my favorite little lenses with the mirrorless system from Canon. In conclusion, this camera is actually surprisingly good for video. Now, if this camera costs $2,000, I would not be saying that. But because this camera can be bought at $600 to $700, give or take, it's actually pretty impressive for what it can do. It's got the amazing dual pixel autofocus and the great 1080p quality for everyday shooting. And with the workarounds, the 4K is actually usable. We hope you guys enjoyed this video about video on the M50. If you're not following us on Instagram, please do that. We're at KinaticaTV. We're posting there regularly, and thank you guys so much for subscribing. In fact, we just hit our 10,000 subscriber mark, and we're so thankful for you guys for sticking around. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. We're growing and making more and more content as regularly as possible. In fact, we're experimenting with live streaming with this camera here. So let us know what you think about that. What do you guys think about the M50? Is it a good video camera? Let us know in the comment section below. Once again, I am Dave Altizer. This is Kinetica. See you next time.